My name is Jillian Hammer. I am the Group Chief Marketing Officer for Databank, and I will be your host today, virtually, of course. So welcome, and I will get started. Before we get started, though, I would just like to let everyone know that we have a program that is packed and ready to go. So hold on to your seats and enjoy, sing along when the opportunity arises to sing along. And it will be our pleasure to have you on board. So we will get started right now. Okay, give me one moment. All right. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I will call on one of our heads of sales, Emma Somiakwau, to give us the opening prayer. So Emma, if you can unmute yourself and go ahead, then we'll get started. Thank you.
Thank you, Jillian. Let us pray. We'll bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall always be on our lips. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Father, we thank you once again. It has been your grace, it has been your favor for us to see ourselves again. Father, 365 days has gone and come back again to meet us in good health. All that we want to say this afternoon is thank you. We thank you for everything you've given us. We thank you for every opportunity you've given us. And we thank you for Databank. We thank you for our leaders. We thank you for our clients. We thank you for everything. This evening, as we've come together to give thanks and praises to your name, we pray that take control and let everything, Lord, amen. Amen.
Amen, Emma. Thank you very much. Amen and amen. And once again, thank you all for joining. Now, the next thing that we have on our schedule for you is a song ministration by Databank Leadership Voices. For staff, we know ourselves and we know that we have some really wonderful voices within Databank. For the clients who are on board, they may not know that Databank has a standing choir called Databank Leadership Voices. The members change over the years. I mean, from one year to the next, you'll see a few new faces, but the essence of the choir is still there. And so it is my pleasure to have them sing the first song called Eradi. If I have mispronounced it, please forgive me, but enjoy the song. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, Databank Leadership Voices. It was a pleasure to hear you. So now we will actually have a few words from our group CEO, Kojo Adai-Mensa, who will tell us, will basically welcome you and explain why we are here. Now, Just out of interest, in case anybody is hearing some nice reggae music going in the background, yes, I am Jamaican, but it's not because of me. Our next door neighbors are having an event, and there's an event center next door. So they have just chosen the same time as our Thanksgiving service to start playing music. So if you hear some distant music, that's why we are doing that. So I would like to welcome Kojo up to just say a few words. Thank you very much. Kojo, over to you.
Thank you very much, Jillian. And I hope you can all hear me loud and clear. Production team, if you're not hearing me, let me know, but I will kick off. So a very hearty afternoon to all ladies and gentlemen across the globe. It is my pleasure to welcome you to Databank's annual Thanksgiving service. So this is the first time we are holding the year-end Thanksgiving service in a virtual format. Some of you may know that in April, we did hold our specific 30th anniversary one also in virtual mode. But I believe this year, December zone will be better. So while I will admit that I will miss seeing you all in person and especially dance with you, you saw me dancing solo in the background there. I really, really miss the dancing bit and the hugging and the shaking and the greetings. But hey, at least we have been able to hold the service. So, and I am very thrilled that so many of you are able to participate, especially not those of you just in Accra, but across the country and across the world. 2020 definitely has been an interesting year, full of ups and downs, but we have all been unwilling participants in the global pandemic, no doubt. Some of us have lost friends or family members, while others have also seen their businesses and jobs gravely impacted, mostly negatively, but some also positively. It's been really a humbling experience. And I believe for all of us, I don't think there's anybody out there whose life or livelihood has not been touched by COVID in one way or the other. So it's for this reason that I believe it is even more critical that we are gathered here today virtually. If for nothing at all, each person participating in this service can be thankful that we have still been given the gift of life. And as long as you have life, then you have hope. So I call on each of you today to reflect on the blessings you still have in spite of anyone or anything you may have lost, and give thanks. Give thanks for your friends, for your family, for your loved ones, for the fact that you have a place to lay your head, food to eat. Give thanks, knowing that even though we are in the midst of COVID, this too shall pass. So it is with the same spirit of thankfulness that I stand before you today, virtually. I'm sitting actually. And give thanks for Databank. I am thankful for our founders, our shareholders, our directors, our business partners, our clients, and our staff. This year, we celebrate 30 years in business. 30 years of serving Ghanaians and helping them achieve their financial dreams. And for that, as it is boldly stated on the front of our head office, to God be the glory. So once again, I welcome you to our Thanksgiving service. I thank you for being a part of Databank story, whether it's been for the past 3 weeks, or 3 days, 3 weeks, 3 months, or the past 30 years. I wish you every blessing during the holiday period and beyond, and pray that you all keep the protocols and stay safe. Thank you. And God bless you all, and I hope you will enjoy the program.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Kojo. I am grateful for your words, and we are very appreciative. So we will now move into our hymn, and this is a favorite hymn of Databank called Now Thank We All Our God. The words will be on the screen so you can sing along. It's not a very long hymn, but we encourage you to participate from your homes, offices, wherever you are, and sing along with us. So again, this will be led by the Databank Leadership Voices. And Databank Leadership Voices. So before we move into our intercessory prayer, I would actually just like to pause and welcome Kelly. I saw his video pop up earlier, and also welcome one of our shareholders, our most, I'm not sure how I would describe Mr. Cashin, but I would say maybe favorite shareholder. But Steve, welcome as well. We have a number of people who have logged in from across Ghana. We also have people who have logged in from the US and many other countries. Gerald, I see you. Welcome. I would also like to welcome the board members of some of our mutual funds as well. We're very grateful to have you here. And to all the clients that are on board, let me also just say welcome at this moment. So at this time, we'll move into the intercessory prayers, where we would just like to pray on behalf of a number of topics. The first one that we will take is Ghana and those affected by COVID-19 worldwide. As you all know, COVID it's been a very interesting experience, because for the first time, you can call anyone anywhere in the world, any time zone, anything, and you can talk to them and they know exactly what you're going through, because we are in the midst of a global pandemic. And the way it has shaken us, most of us know someone or have unfortunately lost someone. And there are times when I say it's not a small matter, but it really, really isn't, because this pandemic, even though some people treat it as if it doesn't even exist, but it really is wreaking havoc across the world. And for that reason, we really want to pray for Ghana and pray for those affected, both in Ghana and outside, that something will happen and that the pandemic will go away sooner rather than later. So I would like to invite Edna Ahuno. She is one of the fund managers based in Accra, to just lead us in this prayer. Edna, if you can unmute yourself, please, and take this one.
Sure. Thank you very much, Elian. Shall we pray? Our Lord and our God, we want to thank you for this day, and we especially thank you for our beloved nation, Ghana. Thank you for the peace we enjoy as a nation, and thank you for seeing us through the just ended election. Lord, we want to commit the year 2021 to your care, and we pray for wisdom for our leaders in governing our nation. We also want to commit to your care those who have been affected directly or indirectly by this pandemic. Lord, we know that many are aching. We know many have lost their livelihoods, and we pray that you step in, Lord. You are able to turn all things around for our good. And so we pray that we will see light at the end of the tunnel. We pray for our scientists, both in Ghana and abroad, wherever they may be, that you give them wisdom to be able to discover a cure, a vaccine for this pandemic that will work, Lord, to preserve our lives. Father, we continue to pray and ask that, Lord, for Ghana especially, you give our leaders wisdom in making decisions which will strengthen our economy. We pray that you make Ghana great and strong. And we ask all these in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Thank you very much, Edna. We would now like to move to say a prayer for Databank's clients. And I would like to invite Reverend John Odoi Korang, who is also a client of Databank, to lead us in this prayer. Thank you. Reverend, if you can unmute yourself, please, and start.
Thank you very much. Shall we pray?
Wone nyamia woma ye diye. Wone nyamia wo diye nko bada. Yedawasia ensando. Yeyiwaya ensando. Ah, Yedawasia ensando. Oh, Yeyiwaya ensando. Bone nyamia woma ye diye. Bone nyamia wo diye nko bada. Oh, Yedawasia ensando. Yowe, Yeyiwaya ensando. And so, Father, we continue to pray and thank you for your love, your mercy, your grace that has sustained us through the year 2020 and to now. We are so very much grateful unto you, for indeed, but for your grace, where would you have been? It's upon this note that even as we celebrate you for seeing the Databank group through the year, we'll not forget to thank you for the clients. We pray and lift all clients before you, that Lord, you have mercy on us. The psalmist said that who can comprehend the power of your anger? Your wrath is as awesome as the fear you deserve. But Lord, we pray, teach us to realize the brevity of our lives so that we may grow in wisdom. We are praying for wisdom, that your people will not lack wisdom. Every client is before you. Without them, there is no data bank. And so we are praying that you sustain your people with wisdom, that in their going out and coming in, Lord, you will be with us. Yes, oh Lord, come back to us. How long will you delay? Take pity on your servants. Yes, Lord, take pity on us. Satisfy us each morning with your unfailing love, so we may sing for you a joyful song even at the end of our lives. Give us gladness in proportion to our former miseries. You know how COVID-19 has wrecked all our ventures, but we are praying that, Lord, you give us gladness in proportion to our former miseries, that you replace the evil years with good. Let the year we are praying to enter in be a year that is good. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your servants see your work again, and let our children see your glory. And may you, the Lord our God, show us your approval and make our effort successful. In the mighty name of Jesus, yes, make our effort successful. We are praying for all clients who are struggling with their businesses, who have lost some funds and here and there, that Lord, you will sustain us, that even with hope, we will climb into the year 2021, and we know that your hand will do exploits in our lives. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you. If somebody is crying because of a lost one, we are praying that you console them. Let your peace that surpasses all understanding guard our hearts and minds, even in Christ Jesus. We thank you for a year ahead of us, and we know it's going to be a glorious year. To the glory of your holy name, and we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen, Reverend. Amen. Thank you very, very much. I would now like to invite an internal pastor, I would say. He's the sales manager for our East Lagon location, and he goes by the name of Jerry Ajintete. He will pray for Databank's founders, staff, and families. So Jerry, if you can unmute yourself and pray, I would be very grateful. Thank you.
Thank you, Gillian. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we come to you this day with appreciation. We come to you and we want to thank you for all that you have done for us, particularly our founders. We thank you for the grace, the vision, the foresight you gave them that gave birth to this great firm, Databank. We pray that your hand will continually be with them and your grace will be abundant unto them. We also pray for our shareholders. We pray for the board. We pray for all our leaders, Lord, and the management team. We are praying that the grace they need, the wisdom they need, you'll grant it unto them. We also pray for the staff of Databank and the families of Databank, all those who are connected to Databank. We are asking, Lord, that your peace that passes all understanding will reign and rule in the families of all those who are connected to Databank in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray, Lord, that as we look ahead, your grace will be abundant to the firm. And you said in your word, in the scriptures, that the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former. Lord, we are asking that you move Databank from grace to grace, from glory to glory. And Lord, let this firm Databank be a blessing, not just to this generation, but generations afterwards. We thank and bless you because we know you've heard and answered this prayer. We say to you be the glory, Father, to you be the glory, Jesus, to you be the glory, Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Jerry. As we continue, one moment. We actually have a short video presentation that's coming up. Before we start, I would actually now like to also welcome Ken and Angie, one of our founders as well, and Yofi Grant. You know, all of these people are people who, Ken and Kelly started the firm. Steve Cashin, one of our shareholders, has been with us for many, many years. Yofi, I'd also like to acknowledge him as well, has helped to build it. The firm that you see today is one that has been built through the hands or with the hands of so many different people. And for that, we're truly grateful. But what we are most grateful for at this specific point in time and this program is the contribution of our founders. If they didn't have the vision to come back to Ghana and start Databank, we wouldn't be here. Who knows what we'd all be doing, but we certainly wouldn't be doing this right now. And we have Databank celebrated its 30th year in business this year. Earlier in the year, we had a small virtual Thanksgiving service to celebrate 30 years. We showed this video at the time, but I thought it would be very appropriate since we're still in our 30th year to show it one more time in honor of our founders. So for Ken and Kelly, this is a tribute to you from Databank staff and the entire Databank family, not just current staff, but everybody who has passed through here. And then once we get done, I'll welcome some other people to the fold as well and to the service. But Kwavena, thank you also for coming. We're very, very grateful. Okay, so we'll move to the video. Thank you. Well, I hope at least a few of you had a trickle of a tear or something. But even though we've tried to capture the essence of Databank and the impact that Ken and Kelly have had on our lives, the video still doesn't capture fully everything that they have been able to do, but we tried. And really, what I would like everyone to take away from it is that we are all truly, truly grateful for the opportunity to have passed through Databank's doors in some capacity over the past 30 years. And we are, those of us that are here now holding the fort, it is our goal, it is our desire, it is our wish that the input that we are able to put into Databank as a firm will position it in such a way that in the next 30 years, when our children are grown up, Databank will still be the place of choice to work. And it will be because of the seed that Ken and Kelly planted and the watering that every staff member, every board member, every shareholder has done over the past 30 years, every client, every contribution they have made, every deposit they have made has gone into making Databank what it is. And we are truly, truly grateful. So with that, I would like to invite, we'll actually hear from Ken, Kelly, and Steve. We'll just hear a few words from them. I would actually like to invite Ken to come up first. So Angie, if you can unmute yourself, then I'll ask you to start off, followed by Kelly and then Steve. So we'll just hear a few words from our founders. Thank you. Angie, I'm not sure if you can hear me.
I'm there.
Oh, fantastic.
There we go.
All right, awesome.
Hi. Good evening.
Good evening. You can turn on your video if you can, and if you'd like.
It's on.
Is it on?
Oh, it's on, okay.
I can see myself. Yeah.
Okay. Great. Yes, I can see you as well. All right. Yep. See you clearly.
Indeed. Okay. Thank you very much. This is really it's an interesting time to be on this program Thanksgiving, and it's really a blessing, and it's really accentuated because I'm just getting out of a COVID experience in which I was in hospital for about 2 weeks. So we're just recuperating now. And it was some difficult moments in the hospital, but it's good to be alive and one appreciates it more, understands the pain that COVID-19 wreaks, you know, on the body, on people. But it also gave time for a lot of introspection and really to be grateful to God for life, as Kojo reiterated over and over again. So we celebrate 30 years in which we were blessed to begin this firm somewhere in Kantamantu. I still would love to have pictures of the environment that we started from to sow that seed. Ken, Kelly, Toguya, and the first few employees. This was in a cousin's construction firm in which we had one room. With these young, precocious people thinking to build an investment bank from Kantamantu, which was quite laughable. And of course, the first few employees, we had Opoku Jamfi, but, and then we had Joanna Arthur. Then of course, Jolie, whom we lost a few years ago, and Johnny Aite, who was a cousin of Elise, brother cousin, and really helped us to set up. So that was the beginning. And during that period, been a lot of help from lots of people to bring us to where we are. And we are grateful the Lord always provided at hand for us. But it's amazing, and we went through periods in which we had to borrow to pay salaries. And I remember when we decided to get married, Angie and I, and there was absolutely no cash. And Kelly found an ingenious way to declare a special dividend. I have no clue where he got the money from. but that was declared, and that helped us to get married. I think the beauty of maybe what has happened these 30 years is when you scan the capital markets, you can see the imprint of Databank or the leadership in a sense of various people in important places who have come through the firm, and that therefore germinates in various ways to bring, you know, our shared values in the industry, which, as you know, was what we coined to be leap high, leadership, excellence, humility and integrity as core principles of what we stand for. You know, I feel like the issue of controversy for the firm really never cease. It's just that if you are the first to carry a pot to the river, you may be the first to break some of those pots. And they are uncomfortable situations for people to accept. But to push for excellence, to push for leadership, would have its own issues. I think one of the other issues has really been the firm coming to terms, as Kojo mentioned, to the clarity that it is only God and Jesus Christ that would support us, and the courage to put that on the building and stand firm by that. But I think for all of you, it just stands to reason that no sudden destruction would ever befall the firm, and that you are in a good place. I remember Enesa Corey as general manager when we were building, and eventually we choosing the upstairs room for meditation, which was really sort of the best room in the house, and just understanding that it is through him that we are where we are. The values are important, a clarity by management to really believe in what is on the building, to God be the glory. And we just ensure your leadership, your dominance for generations to come. And truly, what are you doing? You are really seeking economic freedom and independence for people, showing them how to save their money, invest your money, and use it well. And that is a good thing. Then your Databank Foundation, I remember Kelly just did all he could to make sure we had this crash. Because we're saying that, you know, your values from home to work should not change. It should be seamless. And the sense of family should continue from home to work. And I think we've tried in our own way to establish that, which the current leadership is continuing. And so your work in education, your work of mental health, you know, the leadership choir, just all of those things just creates a bonding and a certain distinct differentness that people feel about the company, even as they leave, and wherever they go, they try to institutionalize some of those elements that they have experienced. And surely, I mean, I guess when I go through the videos, I barely recognize anybody these days, but certainly, you know, Edna and Evelyn and Pani and Amma and, you know, all those guys are still very fondly remembered. For me, taking away from all that Databank gave me to the Republic or government services, I think one of the first things we did at the Ministry of Finance was also to institutionalize a morning devotion at 6:30 every Tuesday. And as we look at the enormity of the work that we have gone through and experience, it is just quite clear that there have been so many Red Sea experiences in which God's hand has been very evident and clear, and will continue in that mode. So I really truly would like to thank you all for the 30 years of experience. Without you, it wouldn't have happened. To thank the numerous clients that you continue to serve, to over 500,000, you know, have assets of over 6 billion under management, 230 staff or so continue to dominate the stock exchange, 19 branches. I mean, we just couldn't have imagined that, and what now, Kojo Frankie, Jillian, and the others, you are managing and progressing. So we wish you well, but don't stumble with controversy. Just like Peter, don't bother with the waves. Just look on Jesus's face, and be laser focused on what you have to do. You will stand, and many will fall. We've gone through 30 years, seen some pyrrhic companies come and go, and steadily Databank continues because you are engulfed in the Lord. So for me, 30 years, very humbling, and wanting to take the opportunity to thank the leadership to keep these values going, even in difficult times. Know that the Lord will continue to protect and prosper and help you bring economic independence to individuals and to the nation. You know, so we thank you again. And it's I'm usually breathless after 30 minutes these days, but I'm sure I'll recapture my energy in the next couple of weeks. So God bless us. God bless you all. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you very much, Ken. We are really, really, really grateful that you were able to join us. Thank you. Angie, thank you for operating from behind the scenes. As we all know, behind every man is an amazing woman. So, Angie, thank you, because Databank would still not be here without the support of you and Kelly's wife as well. So it is indeed a family affair. So you can come into the camera just a little more. Yes, perfect. So that everybody can see you. So guys, this is Ken's other half. Some will say better half. It's his half. But Angie, thank you so much for everything that you do behind the scenes, because most times you're very quiet and in the background, but nonetheless, your impact is felt. So we are most grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Ken, we wish you a wonderful day. Thank you so much for joining as well. So now it is my pleasure to welcome Kelly to say a few words. Kelly, you are looking, hey, I'm liking your background. I can see the trees moving in the background. So welcome. We are waiting to hear from you.
Fantastic. Well, I don't have a whole lot to say to add to what Ken has said. It's been a glorious 30 years. But first, let me say a big thank you to all of you, especially Jillian, who's organized this thing. I've been looking at a counter, and so far we have about 167 people, which I am quite sure would be a record, even if we were having an in-person Thanksgiving as we would have normally done at Asprey. So job well done. Somehow you've managed to, it's now 169. You've managed to bring us all together, and the spirit is still strong. 30 years has been great. It's come rather fast, as I'm concerned. But I think outside of the blessing of founding and surviving, is also the blessing of being able to pass the baton on to the current leadership has done what I see as a very important job of rooting Databank as an institution, at the same time as growing the assets and the management, and also sustaining, particularly sustaining our values, which should remain unshakable. As Ken said, the impact means a lot more to us, and is really what motivates us more than anything. And so far as you've grabbed that baton and you're running just as fast, if not even actually faster, the fact that you're able to maintain our values and keep a culture that makes it worthwhile for the many very strong young men and women to remain and also do the work, we're very grateful. Thank you, the silent ones like Mr. Frankie Hayford, who has been with us forever, started in the Gambia, and then we sneaked him into Accra, and he's been a stalwart. Thank you, Jillian, for picking up just as I was leaving. I'm glad that we made that choice. And of course, the boss man, you've held the fort, and on the celebration of our 30th anniversary, I'll have to say you've earned yourself a sizable chunk of the history of Databank. I thank you all, our clients, the staff, the team, Databank team, and most of all, I thank God for his grace and his mercy on us. So many times in those days around the, what we used to have a round table in the office, Ken and I, and would sit and be talking and sharing ideas. So many times the outcome of things, whether planned or unplanned, would be so clear to us that the hand of God was on us. And if you want to know why we have the inscription on the top of the building, is because it was that clear. It really was that clear. This was not the machinations and the plans of men. This was really the grace of God. And we're very grateful for that glory. And I urge all of you to continue to look to him, particularly when times get a bit tricky, because he will always be there for us. I believe so. So thank you. God bless. Enjoy the holidays. Be safe. And let's meet again on the other side of the year. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Kelly. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And Kojo is beside me. He'll say something to you after. Okay. He's hiding because he wants you guys to have the spotlight for the moment. But again, I personally would like to say thank you just for your support over the 6 years I have been here. And again, earlier today, Kojo and I were actually, he was doing the interview. I was sitting beside him. But one of the things, somebody was asking him, what makes Databank so unique and what has made us so successful? And one of the things that we spoke about was the fact that there are not many owners of companies who, one, are willing to let go and willing to trust their company into somebody else's hands. And you and Ken did that. You did it with Kojo. Frankie is here. But you've entrusted all of us to run what you started. So we're most grateful for that opportunity. And thank you very, very much. Okay, so now I would like to invite Steve Cashin, who is our shareholder, coming in all the way from the US of A, Washington, DC. Steve, if you can, yes, I see your camera. I'd like to welcome you. And wow, you look so sharp.
It's the Thanksgiving service. I was told that I had to be appropriately dressed.
Wow, you really went all out. So can you, if you could, I'm looking, I want to see the pocket thing.
Oh, you know, I need you to sit up just a little bit more.
Yeah. Oh, Steve, thank you so much for joining as well. Really, really grateful. So I would like to turn it over to you.
Jillian, thank you. Jillian, with all due respect, you suggested that Mrs. Aforiata was quiet and in the background. It is not the Mrs. Aforiata that I know. She has a very strong backbone, and we are very grateful for that backbone. And we are very grateful to having her serve on our board as we've lost her husband to public service. And having shared him to public service for 4 years and then an accompanying few years in before, we wonder whether we might get him back sometime, but we'll have that discussion later. I'd like to keep my comments in the theme of family. I came to Ghana as a young boy 53 years ago in 1967. At the time, my father's counterpart was a dashing young man who was the youngest assistant minister of finance that Ghana had had, a man named Dr. Jones Aforiata. A man with a wry wit, a sharp acumen, sometimes a sharper tongue, who all of us loved in many ways. And I'd like to honor his life, which recently passed after a long fruitful and accomplished life. I'd like to offer my comments to his memory. So my time with Databank really began 53 years ago, before Databank was even considered. It then came back in 1990 when I was furiously working at the Bank of Uganda to do another facility with an extremely difficult advisor named Dr. Jones Aforiata, who made me work for every bit of business that I got, but always would celebrate with me afterwards with a bit of a drink that his son has not carried on in the same way, along with a cigar. And at the time he said to me, you know, my son is beginning a bank and my son is smarter than I am. And you will make a lot of money if you invest in my son's bank. Lo and behold, a few years later, that opportunity presented itself. And as our former chair said, he wasn't afraid to break a few pots. And as an institution, even though Frankie doesn't like it when we break the pots, we've continued to break pots. And we only break pots in order to progress even further. But we're doing it, we do it in a manner that is honorable, that is focused, that is has demonstrated successes that have never been seen in Ghana before. Who would have thought that Databank would have, in my parlance, over $1 billion under management? That's an amazing, amazing achievement. And that achievement is only the foundation of what will continue. Most of you are in your 30s and 40s. I work most closely with a group of young women and men who have spent the last 5 years really building upon the foundation that Ken and Kelly created and cleaning up a foundation that we left for you to a position where there are huge opportunities going forward. Not only in terms of asset management, but in terms of structured finance, Frankie.
Intent.
And we can't be scared of the noise that we might create in terms of achieving that. We will create noise, and we will also create success for many of the people of Ghana and throughout Africa. This success is built upon family, as I said. And it is not only to Jones that I offer this tribute, but to the Aforiata, Gajapo, and all of the Databank families who have put so much into this institution and who we see continuing with this institution. Mm-hmm. So to them, to the Almighty, to all of you, thank you. I wish you all a wonderful holiday season. I wish you all goodbye to 2020 and hello to 2021. And I pray for all the successes that we can achieve in 2021. And I promise to all of you that I will escort Mr. Trump out of the White House in 2021, and we will not have to deal with him again. To all of you, thank you for being such wonderful partners, wonderful supporters, and happy new year, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, Steve. Okay, Kojo has some words to say, sorry.
Okay, so this was not part of the program. I acknowledge that we are running behind time, but I think I need to really say a big thank you to our shareholders. Honestly, walking into those shoes was the scariest moment of my life, to walk into the shoes of Ken, Kelly, and Co. But I would really especially want to thank them for the free hand they have given me and my team to operate. And for the benefit of the clients, I mean, some clients honestly think that I wake up in the morning and have breakfast with Ken and have lunch with Kelly and then have dinner with the president. It sometimes amazes me. But just to inform you and to confirm today that you have heard yourselves that we have complete independence in what we do. They have given us a free hand. And thank you for the confidence that you have given to or reposed in me and my team for pushing the agenda and the vision. That's all I really, really want to say a thank you for, because it doesn't happen in Ghana where founders especially will just hand over a firm, turn back, and not even be looking over your shoulder. And I think it's a big, 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 big deal. So thank you guys. And I can assure you that we are fully focused and unwavered with all the noises that usually come up. And we, because of that, and the belief in God, Kelly, that is what has made us forge ahead. And we will continue to forge ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So Steve, thank you again for your words. Kelly and Ken, thank you also. And to echo what Kojo said, thank you for your faith in us. So at this point, we will return to the next section of our program, which is a Bible reading. So just give me one moment, please. Let me restart. Okay. So at this point, I would like to invite Dorcas Doe. She's a member of the Databank Foundation, and she will give us the scripture reading, which is taken from Philippians 4, verses 4 to 9. Dorcas, you can unmute yourself and go ahead, please.
Thank Philippians chapter 4 from verse 4 to 9. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received, and heard and see in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very, very much, Dorcas. And the scripture that Dorcas read, many of us on this call or in this service, we know it. We've heard it 1,000 times. But, you know, the most important thing that I would wish that everybody would take away from it is the part about not being anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. There is nothing as powerful as giving thanks. And 2020 has been a year of extremes in many, many ways. People have lost jobs, they've lost family, that there's so many things that we have experienced. But even in the bad, there has been good. And it is so important that we can all pause today and give thanks. In fact, earlier this week, I was speaking to someone and I was saying to him, oh, I have a Thanksgiving service this Thursday. And he was saying, for your church? And I said, no, for Databank. There are many, many, many companies that will never pause to say thanks to God. And what Databank has, and I was so proud to be able to say, but Databank, this is something we do. And I mean, it's been done since the beginning of the firm. When we have meetings, we start with a prayer. Those small things, they're most companies do not do them, but it is what sets us apart. And it is what I believe has helped to keep us in spite of everything that has gone on around us. And so truly, truly, we are thankful to God, and we're thankful to the clients who have just been with us and believed in us with their funds, with their finances. And we're very, very grateful for that. So just a quick commentary on the scripture. Now, we will be heading into the sermon, but right before that, we have a brief song that we would like to have you listen to, again performed by Databank Leadership Voices. This one, the words are there, and in English, it's called Holy King. Otherwise, as Okonkwo Henny. Again, please, if I have slaughtered the word, please forgive me, but nonetheless, take a moment and enjoy the song.
You know.
Just a brief musical interlude. And one moment, could you? One moment. Okay. Sorry. So now it is actually my pleasure to invite our spiritual partner in crime, for want of a better word, Reverend Albert Okran. He is going to come and share a brief word with us, but this is something he has been doing since 2014. I think so, 2014. He's been with us year in, year out. And the amazing thing is that every single year, we will give him the theme with virtually no direction, nothing. And he will come and the messages will be bang on. Absolutely in line with what, as a leadership team, with the thoughts that we have for the coming year. So without any further ado, it is my pleasure to welcome Reverend Albert Okran. Please give him a round of applause. Okay, I'll do it on your behalf. Reverend, welcome. One moment.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to be here, to be part of this 30th anniversary Thanksgiving service. I know you had one earlier in the year, but this is another day and God has been good. Would you kindly bow down your heads with me for a word of prayer? Father, we thank you for your faithfulness, your goodness and your mercy. We thank you for the authority of your word and pray that this brief time looking into your scriptures will be instructive, inspirational, and uplifting for someone, in Jesus' name, amen. Let me add my voice to celebrate first Ken, who has been a mentor to me for several years and has played a very significant role, along with Angie, in my life and that of Comfort over the years. The 30 years of Databank, I believe that I've been around Databank for 25 of the 30 years. So I don't know whether to call myself an alumnus or an associate, but a part of the family, and very proud to be part of this. Let me salute Kelly, who has become my big brother, and who I think this year I've spent more time with Kelly this year than every other year in our over the years. Kelly, you're on mute, but I can see you're talking. So Kelly has become that big brother that I pinch and I go to every single time. Let me salute Steve Hashin joining us from all from across the world and everyone here on the platform. I would like to share a few thoughts on distinction, because I heard Ken and Kelly emphasize that in spite of every accomplishment, let us remain Databank. Let us remain true to our values, true to what the firm has been. And so for the benefit of those who have joined Databank not too long ago, or those who did not experience the beginnings, let me stay with a theme that will remind us of what Databank is and what we are as part of this family. So in the next 15 minutes, I want to share about distinction. The first thing I want to say is distinction is about daring to be different. Daring to be different. I believe with all my heart that everyone must dare to be different. And even more importantly, Databank must dare to be different. Databank is not EDC. Databank is not that other company out there. And guess what? You are also not that other person. Distinction relates to the difference between similar things or people. So you will say this is another investment company, another fund management company, or another individual working in the firm. But it is about the excellence that sets you apart, that sets apart someone or something from others. If you can find a voice, say, I am different. I am unique and I am excellent. So let's take our foundational scripture from Daniel chapter 6, verse 3. Daniel 6, verse 3. And it says, then this Daniel, you can put your name there, this Kojo, this Jillian, this Kelly, this yourself. Then this Jillian distinguished herself above the governors and the satraps because an excellent spirit was in her, and the king gave thought to setting her over the whole realm. Let me read the original version before you accuse me of distorting scripture. Then this Daniel distinguished himself above the governors and satraps because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought or considered setting him over the whole realm. I would like to reduce this to a formula for the benefit of the mathematical ones among us and say that the key words in this verse are distinguished. Daniel distinguished himself. We're talking about distinction, that which sets you apart. And so Daniel was diligent. He distinguished himself above all other governors, all other fund managers, all others holding similar roles. Daniel distinguished himself. Why? Because an excellent spirit was in him. That speaks about attitude. So let me submit that diligence plus attitude equals to promotion. So promotion was the king considering that Daniel could qualify to oversee the whole operation, the whole realm, the whole kingdom. Distinction, friends, is deliberate. Daniel did not accidentally get promoted. He did not accidentally find himself holding the same distinguished position under different kings at different times. It was because there was a quality in him that was evident. Let me explain that distinction is manifested in three ways. The first level of distinction is being among the people by looking different. I will call that variation. Variation. That means that you are with your colleagues, but there is increased visibility. Something about you makes you different from everyone else. When the client says, when I deal with you, something about you makes me feel assured that my funds are safe or that you understand my need. You are with the others, but your visibility, you stand out. When the whole group meets, you stand out in the lot and there is variation. You look different. You behave different. You go different from how others do it. The second level is where you take yourself a step beyond where everyone else will stop. So that person who goes the extra mile to send a statement, to call the client and say, do you understand the statement? Explain the options available to them. That is setting yourself apart from everyone else. I want to challenge somebody and say that it is not enough to do what is required of you and to say, we were told to do this and I've done it. The real standard is to say, can I go a step further and make this even better?
even different, even more comfortable for the client, especially at a time like this. That is separating yourself or setting yourself apart from everyone else who stops exactly where they are required to stop. But the ultimate level that we must aspire to is the third level, and that is elevation, where you don't just move ahead of the rest, but you climb to a higher position. I love elevation because it gives you a certain competitive advantage. You stand in a place where you can see what others don't see. You can do what others cannot do because you are elevated, you are risen, you stand from a superior position. And that person is in green, and that is where Databank belongs. Elevated, superior, more competitive, at an advantageous position. I believe it is scriptural, it is godly, it is Christ-like to be superior in your solutions, your offerings, your service to the competition. And every member of this team must aspire to be at that place where when you deliver, there is an X factor, something that people say, that is the it, you are the one. And that is the standard that we must aspire to. Let me say that your elevation determines your perspective. The higher you stand, the further you can see. A person standing on top of a story building can tell you that there's a rainstorm or there is a flood coming or there's a crowd moving. And that from that position, they can tell with more certainty than a person standing at the base of a ladder. So that elevated position gives you a better perspective of life, of the market, of the competition, of the future, and of the actions required to stay ahead of the pack. How do we elevate? How does the individual elevate from the perspective of the scriptures? First is to have a deep understanding of God's word. What does God's word say about what we are doing? When we say to God be the glory, what does it mean? Is it scriptural? Is it anchored in God's promise and God's word? And that is the word of God. The second thing is prayer. Every day, commit your ways to the Lord and ask for wisdom for the year that is ahead of us, that he will give us an understanding of where the wind will blow, so that before anyone moves, we are already there and we are leading from the front. The third is renewed thinking. Some of what we are used to will continually be changed in the light of a changing world. The World Economic Forum predicts that there will be many more people working from home now than they are currently. But guess what? It says 94% of employers expect their staff to develop new skills to be able to continue operating on the job. And 40% of those new skills must be acquired in the next 6 months. Where does that leave you? Renewed thinking about what is required to stay on top in Databank and in the job that you have chosen to do. The fourth is acting with wisdom. Wisdom is profitable in all things. And so every one of us seeking to elevate must ask God for wisdom. It's the prayer that God approves. The Bible says, if anyone lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives freely and will never rebuke you for asking for wisdom. Every morning you wake up, ask God for wisdom. And the final way to elevate is being grateful. Just being grateful, being thankful that you are alive, being thankful that you are performing, being thankful that you have a good company to work in, being thankful that your company is alive and strong. So many things we take for granted are blessings from God. So let me begin to wind down and say that the three hallmarks for distinction are found in Jeremiah 18. And let me read from verse 1 to verse 6. Jeremiah, let me bring Gillian on to come and read this one. I've opened it for you. Jeremiah 18, verse 1 to 6.
Okay, Jeremiah 18, verse 1 to 6 says, the word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, making something at the wheel. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again into another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to make. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, can I not do with you as this potter, says the Lord? Look, as the clay is in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Amen.
The word of the Lord, thanks be to God. As the clay is in the potter's house, so are you in my hand, O house of Databank. That is the word of the Lord to somebody. As the clay is in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Emma, O house of Daniel, O house of Jillian, O house of Kuju. Every single one of us is in the hand of the Lord. And Bible says that as God created something beautiful out of the clay, there were times when the clay was marred, but God refixed it and molded it into something beautiful. May I suggest that something beautiful will come out of your life. Something awesome, something amazing will come out of your life as you submit yourself in the hands of the Lord. So what are the three hallmarks of distinction I want to leave you with? Number one is uniqueness. No one is a mistake. Every one of us is unique, created by God with distinction for a particular purpose. You are unique in your identity, unique in your assignment, unique in your location, unique in your composition, and unique in your value proposition. Everyone on this team must ask yourself, who am I? What have I been called to do in this team? Why have I been placed in this branch, in this division, in this location? What am I made up of? And most importantly, what value am I required to bring to the table? Once you understand that, you don't look at somebody else. You run your race, you run with distinction, and you run to win the race. The first is uniqueness. The second is understanding. Bible says that when God was creating the clay, something beautiful out of the clay, there was an end, but there was also a process, sometimes a difficult process. And there were times when it didn't go too well. But understand your destination, that God is working on something with your life. Understand the seasons of your life. There are seasons when everything is so right, and there are seasons when things are so tough, but you keep pushing through to get to your destination. Understand your strategy. How do you intend to get the results that you're looking for? Understand your resources. What has God given you as an individual and as a company? And above all, understand your relationships. Who has God put in your life to help you to get to your desired destination? And that is very important. The final U is urgency. I want to dedicate this to the CEO for very good reason. In the year 2020, the companies that did well were those that were urgent. Urgent, forgive me. So uniqueness was the first of identity, of assignment, of location, of composition, and of value. We spoke also about understanding the destination that you are going to, the seasons of your life, the strategy you are pursuing, the resources God has blessed you with, and I love the relationships. It is very important to understand the relationships God has given you to help you get to your destination, because they would facilitate your arrival there. But a third U, beyond uniqueness and understanding, is urgency. In the year 2020, the companies that did well were those who responded quickly to the rapid changes the world experienced as a result of COVID. Someone said there is COVID-20, that is the aftermath or after effects of COVID-19. And may I suggest that as we go through this COVID-20 period, it is imperative that we act with urgency. urgency with our time. There must be momentum in our movement. So if 2020 has been good, in 2021, let's not drop the momentum. Let's keep pushing. It also requires alertness, always on the lookout, anticipating where the next door will open and readiness to go through that door. The fourth point under urgency is adaptability, flexibility. When things change, let's be willing, ready, available to change and to keep changing and taking advantage. The final one, guess what? It's execution. It's not about what we see. It's not about what we plan. It's not about what we discuss. It's about what we do to get the results for this company and for generations to come. Let me urge all of us in the coming year to appreciate our uniqueness, to appreciate and understand why we are in this company, and to run with urgency towards the desired destination. As I close, I would ask us to pray, and the prayer is very simple. Ask God for grace. Grace to separate yourself from the crowd and to elevate yourself to the highest point of distinction in everything that you do. Let's pray together. For just a minute, ask God for grace to separate yourself. Tell yourself, I must be different. Something about me must stand out. I must be unique. I must understand the times. I must know what to do. Help me, Lord, to elevate myself to the highest point of distinction. The middle is not enough. Close to the top is not enough. I must be at the very top in everything I do. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the entrance of your word. Let there be light. Let there be understanding. Let there be illumination. Let there be inspiration. And may someone rise up and say, because I am in Databank, in the year 2021, Databank will rise to an even higher level than we have been in the year 2020. Equip all of us, strengthen us from the CEO through the exco, the leadership, all the way to the very newest person in the team. Strengthen us, help us, and uphold us with your victorious right hand. May the year 2021 be a year of distinction for Databank, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Merry Christmas. God bless you all, and a happy and prosperous year of distinction to us all, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen and amen. Albert, thank you so very, very, very much. I hope you took notes. I did. Here are my notes, if anybody would like to see. But, you know, it's, I think the three words maybe that I'll take, and there were a lot of words, but it was the levels of distinction. And the reason why those three words resonated with me is because even though he's giving the message at the Databank Thanksgiving program, those three words apply to you wherever you are, whether you are running your own business, whether you are an employee, whatever it is, these three words can apply to you and you can use it to become distinct in whatever you do. So the three words, that the three levels of distinction that he mentioned, one, variation. Number one. Level two, separation. Separate yourself. And level three, elevation. And the perspective is always higher or different based on your level of elevation. So at this point in time, we would just like to welcome the perspective of three of our clients. And we've asked them to share a few words. So the first person that we will welcome is Mr. Philip Aboa from Kumasi. He's been a client with us since 2009,
And Philip, within a minute or less, we would just like you to just share a few words about what Databank, the impact or what Databank has done for you. But thank you so much for taking the time to participate in this program. Over to you, Philip. Please unmute yourself.
Okay. Hello, can you all hear me?
Yes, we can.
Okay, thank you very much for the opportunity. My name is Philip Abua, and I'm an architect by profession. I joined Databank in the year 2009, so close to 11 years, I should put it. And in fact, I've really enjoyed being with you guys. And before I normally embark on a journey with a company, I normally am committed to the hands of the Lord. And in fact, I would also want to say again that I'm really happy to be with you guys. I've been seeing what is going on in the economy of our country. But in joining you guys, in fact, I know the Lord is with you. Keep on, and everything is going to be well. I've been recommending you guys to a lot of friends, especially when the economy started dwindling. I was advising people to always come to you guys, but then they were always giving me excuses here and there. But I kept on moving and moving and moving, always enjoying blessings from you guys. And in fact, it's been good. One thing I would want to encourage you guys to do is to keep on with your transparency. Keep on working hard, and everything is going to be well. I've been saving close to 11 years, and I've never had any issues with you guys. No problems.
Thank you, Philip.
No problems with deposits. I'm able to keep track of my investments. It has been awesome. All I want to say is keep on with the good work. And the good Lord who sees everything is going to bless you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Philip.
I've been able to recommend you guys to about 4 people, and now currently they are with you. And I'm still on it. I'm bringing more people on board because I know the kind of work you are doing. Keep on. Thank you so much for the opportunity to also share my thoughts on what is going on with Databank.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you. We're most, most grateful for your feedback. And, you know, I'm glad you have been able to say your experience has been all good. There's no company that's perfect. We all have our good days and bad days, and we all have things we'd like to do better. But nevertheless, we are very, very grateful for having you on board and having you on board for so long. So thank you again, Philip, and we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year when it comes. There are 2 more clients that will speak. The next client is Joanna Amerle Ajedu. She is from the US. She's been with us. She started investing with Databank last year. She was supposed to actually speak live and she couldn't, but she really wanted to share her thoughts. So she sent us a 1-minute recording. So I'll play that and then we'll move to Danielle, who is the last person that will share.
Hello, I would have loved to join you, but I had another engagement to attend to. So when I think about Databank, the word that comes to mind is efficiency. I couldn't be more pleased with the health of my portfolio and the tools the bank provides for easy access. Also, with all of the global implications of COVID-19, it is reassuring to see my portfolio has retained its health. I've been very impressed with the customer service. I recollect an occasion when I had attempted to do business with another major bank, but the desire was very short-lived when it became apparent that Databank had set the customer service bar very high. I want to use this opportunity to dole out buckets of praises to Josephine Oforiata. She's always available every time I have questions and her professionalism is one that is beyond exceptional. I also want to say thank you to Databank for the amazing work you're doing. It is comforting to know that my money is being managed well. I wish each and every one of you a Merry Christmas and a super 2021.
All right, and that was a quick message from Joanna. And then the last person that we have up and as a client is Daniel Afori. Daniel has been with us since 1996. So I am fairly positive that his ride has not always been smooth, but nonetheless, he has stuck with us for the last 24 years. Daniel, to be 25 next year's 25 years next year. So thank you for taking the time and staying on for the whole program so that you could share with us. We're really, really grateful to have you speak. Please go ahead.
I'm so grateful for this opportunity to share my thoughts. Databank has been wonderful. In fact, as soon as I read about Databank in the newspaper that you are on track, I just came to your office the next day. And then I asked a ton of questions. And immediately I signed my three children on. In fact, they were one of the first 100 clients that you had. And I kept on putting money in there every month religiously. About a year or so later, then I signed myself up, my wife and myself. And three highlights that I have with my investment in Databank. There was a time when my daughter needed, quick money to pay her school fees in the university. And we've been saving with Databank for just about three years, small monies every month, but we'll do it very religiously. After 3 years, when I went to the bank to check, we have 24 million CDs then. And that was just enough to pay for her school fees. We continued. I signed up all my workers. In fact, right now, I have brought in my workers. My school, we have about 103 workers, which all of them are in Databank. My landscaping business, I have about 15, 20 that time. I brought all of them in. Some of them have left the company. But all of them have good, story to tell. Some have used their investment to build a chamber hall in their villages. Some have been using it to pay their children's school fees regularly. Even in my school, many, many, many of the staff members have been using their investment to be paying for higher education. And I sit back and I look and I say, oh, how wonderful. And I don't stop that, stop there. I've asked the Databank to come to my church. They've talked to my church 2-3 times. And many have already gone, but they call me Databank. They call me Databank in my church. Because I'm always talking about Databank. When I take a taxi, I ask the taxi driver, how much have you been making? Do you know about Databank? If you put your money every week, put your money in Databank, within about 3, 4, 5 years, you'll be able to own your own car. And it's a revelation to them. They never knew that if they put their money somewhere small, over a period of time, they'll be able to have enough money to buy their own car and become a car owner and a business owner and that kind of stuff. And all these things from data, but this is a wonderful opportunity that Databank has given us. And for our school, as an entity, we make so much money. And out of our profits every year from Databank, we're able to do small things, renovation works, do this, do that, and do that. One last thing I want to say about my school, when I asked them all to join, in fact, we started paying 5 CDs per every staff member every month. And then they kept on saying that we should add more. I said, I won't add more. I'm only teasing you so that you must put your own money in there. Every time I kept on telling my staff, put money in Databank, add some to what you are giving. And they never did. And one staff member had a note from Databank after 6 years of we paying 5 CDs every month in there. He had a slip from Databank saying that the total amount of money he has there was 1,600 CDs, when in actual fact it should have been 360 CDs over the 6 years. He had 1,600 CDs. He broadcasted it in the school. That was the month they all went and told the accountant, please put 100 CDs every month, put 50 CDs every month, and so on and so forth. And out of that 50 CDs and 100 CDs and every month, they'll be able to pay all their school fees, they are paying on the higher education, their children's school fees, building a house, buying a plot here, there, and there. And now they see the wisdom in putting monies aside little by little by little. And as the Bible says, if you put your monies little by little by little, in time, it will grow. And I think Databank has given us a wonderful vehicle, opportunity to be able to do that, to elevate ourselves from whatever lower level, financial level we are, to a higher level. And I'm grateful to God that this opportunity is there. And I'm still there. All my children are still putting money in there. And we are very happy with it. Most of all, our monies are safe. The Amen. Safety of our money is what really gladdens my heart. And once the money is safe, I know that it will grow. So thank you very much, Databank. Ken, I worried Ken in his office so many times. I'll go to his place and ask him all a ton of questions about Databank, how these are performing, blah, blah, blah. And it's been nice. He has been open. The doors are always open. I have friends in the bank now. You know, what's her name? Josie and one or two others. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Daniel. Thank you. We're very grateful. I mean, that's a wonderful testimonial. And the funny thing is, no matter how much we talk and educate, there's so many more people who need education about investing and the benefits of investing for them. So I'm really, really grateful to hear your testimonial. And I do wish you the happiest of holidays for the rest of this year. Thank you once again. So we are coming to the end of our program. We had hoped to end at 6 p.m. We have actually two items left. In fact, yeah, two items left and very fairly short. And then we'll release all of you at that point. So just bear with us for about 10 more minutes and then we'll be done. So the next item on the agenda, we've heard from the clients and we just wanted to quickly... A few of the team members also wanted to say a quick thank you from us to you. We've thanked the founders earlier, but we do also want to thank our clients who have been with us and just appreciate them. So just stay seated while we run this very short video.
Hi, my name is Jillian Hammer. I am the Group Chief Marketing Officer for Databank. On behalf of the firm, I would like to say thank you. Thank you for being a part of our story and our journey. And thank you for allowing us to be a part of your journey to financial independence. Whether you've been with us 1 week, 1 year, or the past 30 years, we could not have done it without you. And for that, we are grateful and we say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Merci.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Pam.
Thank you.
Another one is short. So we come to the last item before Reverend Albert will come back and say the benediction. And that is actually offering. So most of you are thinking that, virtual service, how will we do offering? Well, for those of you who have never attended a Databank Thanksgiving service, every year we do an offering and then we donate 100% of the funds to some charitable work. This year, we are donating any money that's collected, and the method of doing it will be mobile money. But all the money that we collect will go to a community literacy project that Databank Foundation is running. So just to give you a quick idea of what this is, we have a read aid program where we work with young children to teach them to read. And so the community literacy project, that one focuses on home-based learning for children between KG3 and year 3, where we'll actually be providing tablets to the children so that they can access digital books with lesson plans. And the plan is to start with at least 100 children from households in Nima, Adabraka, Mamobi, and Latibio, Washikoshi. So that's what we plan to do. So in the next 2 or 3 minutes, while the Databank Leadership Voices sings one more quick and final song, you will see the mobile money number come up and the wallet name come up. And I encourage you all, I mean, whatever amount it is, donate, and all of that will be used to help these children learn to read. So once this is done, we'll come back and close the service with our closing prayer and benediction. Thank you. Had sufficient time to see the number and give a donation. If you are able to, thank you very, very much in advance from all of us at Databank, from the foundation team, and from the children who will benefit from what you have given. So at this point, I would just like to invite Albert Okren, Reverend Albert Okren, to come up and give us a closing prayer and benediction, and then we can release you all. So thank you once again for staying with us. One moment while he comes up. Thank you.
Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for this time of fellowship. We've joined our hearts and our souls virtually, but by the power of the Holy Spirit, you've been together as one. We commit ourselves into your hands in this Christmas season. We pray for your protection upon every single one of us and our families. Deliver us from evil, deliver us from pain, deliver us from any form of sickness or accident, deliver us from infection, protect us by day and protect us by night. And in the last few days of this year, perfect everything that concerns us and cause us to see that which you have designed for us in this year 2020. May we not miss our season and our visitation. You are a God who's able to do in one day that which can be done in 1,000 years. Let everyone experience your visitation in the last few days of this year. But above all, take us into 2021 in power and in glory. And let Databank fulfill its mandate in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And now may the peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you and Happy New Year.
Amen and amen and amen. Everyone, thank you so much for giving us your Thursday evening if you're in Ghana, and afternoon if you are somewhere else in the world. We're very, very grateful to have you on board. We wish you a Merry Christmas, a Happy New Year. God bless you all as we play this song, but feel free to enjoy or log off. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.